Hello there, and welcome back to Europa Universalis 4. I'm playing as Holland. It is 1490, and I'm in a war with Bavaria. I'm not really involving myself too much. I've got an event here first. Complaints about the bailiff. A bailiff in one of our provinces has earned a reputation as a greedy and cruel person. The local populace has gathered a petition to have him removed. To lose stability or lose prestige. I think I'll cop the prestige. Okay, that Bavarian army's left. That's good. I was a little bit worried about them. I don't know if I want to marry with Brandenburg anymore. I'm going to decline. I still have a lot of loans. That's my biggest problem at the moment. I still got 24 loans. What I will do, try and get rid of a couple of them. I'm going to ask for a contribution from the burghers. They'll give me 70 ducats. Let's do that. And I can use that to pay off 2 loans. I can use it to pay off 1 loan. That's a shame. I'm actually getting a little bit, not ahead, but I'm actually making a bit of progress. Let's pay off another one. Cool. Oh, there's that Bavarian army, but the war's over. Okay. Decisive victory. I doubt I'm going to get anything out of that at all. Why would I? No. At least the war's over. The other theory, well, not a theory, the other possibility I was running by was, do I start a war to try and get money just through war? Is that a possibility, or is that dangerous? That's the question I need to ask myself. I'm not going to declare war on Utrecht because they've got a lot of alliances lined up. I could bring in France though. I can almost bring in Denmark. I mean, is that a possibility? Just use my powerful allies to help me get some land and hopefully get money out of my defeated enemies. Because it's just going to take a long time, the way I'm going at the moment, to pay off these loans. I can debase my currency again. I'm kind of thinking it's a possibility. They got 5 allies, but I got Denmark and France. They got Alsace, not too bad. They got Salzburg, Genoa. No, it's a risk, that's the thing. It's a risk, but I'm sure it would work out. Their military tech is level 8. Mine is almost 8. Maybe I'll wait till I get my mil tech up. And we'll see what can happen. I just want to hire my conditori. I don't want to give them up. Boundary dispute. The lack of good maps or tools to create accurate maps would occasionally lead to overlapping claims of authority in border regions. These disputes were usually over very marginal areas, but could serve as a point of friction when monarchs decided to press the issue. I don't know. Lose stability, so I guess I'll press the issue and gain a claim on Meppen, which is that province there. And get my claim back on Friesland, so I'll do that. I guess the question is, who's got better allies? Who would have allies willing to be involved? They've got Brabant. Which is right on my doorstep. Whereas Utrecht, they've got Brittany, but Brittany are over here, so France would handle them. East Frisia, Genoa's pretty far away, Alsace, Salzburg. Although I do have a truce with them as well, so that's something going to happen. Friesland, I don't have a truce. Oh, Denmark won't get involved, though. Denmark have started another war. Against Brunswick, Liege, and Nassau. Okay. Innovative is decreasing. It's okay. Almost permanently alone. It seems like it'd be a risky move to try and do a war to get some money, but it also might be... the only way to make money. Or I start a war to try and... with allied England and Friesland. I obviously don't want to upset England. That wouldn't be a very good idea, then, would it? I know, it's interesting. Paraffin alone. Another one out of the way. Interest costs are definitely reducing. So I'm making... every time I paraffin alone, I can pay off... I'm making more money to pay the next one off. So it's a slow progress. I am getting there. When does my truce end with Utrecht? Ah, this year. Okay. I would want to have Denmark and France involved at a minimum. They're now an elector. Does that mean... I don't know. Alright, I can now get Miltech 8 for no penalty, so I'll get that. The Miltech 8 is pike and shot. The arquebus was easy to use as a weapon, but also inaccurate and slow to fire, leaving its user vulnerable to cavalry charges. Blending with pikemen allowed arquebusiers to fire and then fall back to be shielded by pikemen when enemy cavalry or infantry appeared. So it gets me some infantry fire and cavalry shock, so just a bit of a general improvement of my army. It's always good, I guess. I can invest in a new idea. What point do I want to get? Because that's 6, 6, and 8, so I probably should save up and try and get a Diplotech. A bountiful harvest. This year's harvests have been exceptional. Rarely in our nation's history has the earth brought forth so much of its bounty. The populace are already interpreting this as a sign that we're enjoying divine favour. Oh, gained 36 ducats. Thank you. Let me use that to repay another loan. 20 left. I mean, oh. Brabant has declared war in Liege. And get another merchant. I'll probably use the North Sea. But I probably should get my Diplotech up. So it doesn't fall behind the military tech. But then again, another merchant could be handy. Brabant's at war. I can't take advantage of that. Utrecht. The truce with Utrecht is over. Denmark is still busy with their war, so it's not going to happen as long as that's going on. Interesting times, interesting times. Do I want another merchant or do I want the next tech? So we're going to lead to money, though. Now, let's get the merchant. Overseas merchants. Done. To grow trade, we need to extend the rights of citizenship to people who live abroad, support our trade, and are of the right social class. Another merchant to deploy. So I'm already steering from Champagne. I'm already steering from Lübeck. So I need to Increase Rhineland steering into Champagne, or I can increase Baltic Sea trading into Lübeck. Wonder which one's more beneficial. I'm getting steering Rhineland. Steer Rhineland into Champagne up into English Channel. That's probably the best way to go, I think. Well, having said that, both of these steers go into other bonds I'm already steering, so maybe that's not the best idea. Maybe we'll recall him. Maybe I didn't need this merchant after all. I guess the only thing is, if I do the North Sea, the Baltic Sea. Oh, hang on, North Sea. Pushes into the English Channel. Ah! Obviously, I'll do that one. There we go. Excellent, okay. So they're all pushing towards English Channel to give me power there. I'm happy with that. It's only doing a little bit, but everything adds up, doesn't it? England's at war. Liege and Trier. There's Liege. Where's Trier? Ah, down there. What I might do is just start a spy network in Liege. Maybe I can jump on this if the opportunity presents itself. Handle the loan. I'm starting to think that the military route could be a thing. The question is, who do I attack? You could be able to attack Brabant when England are too busy. Attack Utrecht without one of their allies if... How is my inflation going? It's not too bad. 4.3. Corruption's at 7.7. So 19 loans. I'm definitely getting there. I'm making progress. Denmark's finished their war. Okay. They would help me with a war of their own. England want military access? I'll give them that. Repay loan. It's good. I could bring in Denmark, France, and Brandenburg to take down Utrecht. Are Utrecht going to have the money, though? To pay me back. Whereas... Unhappiness among the artisans. Conflicts and protests over taxes, corporations, trade and customs policies are becoming quite frequent and could result in a sharp drop in our industrial production if we don't handle the situation carefully. I don't want to lose ducats. I'm going to execute the troublemakers. I'm going to lose stability and loyalty, but... I think I have to do that at this time. And the burghers are now disloyal. Which is very bad. Being disloyal is very bad. So I might just lose 5 prestige and get them loyal again. Austria no longer a great power? Okay, Brabant's war is finished. They gained a lot of land out of that. And I can't attack them. I need a rival. Let's just go for Utrecht. You know what, I think I might just have to finish Utrecht off. I can declare war. And I can bring in my allies to help out. I wonder if I can convince any of them not to join in. Could I convince East Frisia not to join? Then again, I could piece them out one by one. Alright, let's do it. Let's declare war. Bring all my allies. Goal is to take Utrecht. They get a few allies, I'm sure I can. But if they merge those two armies, I'm in trouble. It's a tricky situation to be in, that's for sure. Depends what East Frisia's army does straight away. How's that inflation going? 4.6, it's still okay. Might debase my currency one more time. And I'll repay a loan. So I'm making 5 ducats a month now, so it's getting pretty good. That's with full, so I can even close that fort. There we go. Okay, I might actually get this loan sorted out quicker than I thought. In front of this... Brandenburg in a war now. Who that war with? Holland and Moldavia? Denmark! Denmark in a offensive war against Lithuania, allied with Saxony. I guess I have to accept. That's just annoying though, because it slows down my plans. There's Saxony. Once again, I don't really want to get involved too much, but then again, there's plenty of allies. Maybe I could just do a bit of raiding. Repent of the loan. Influenza. Rumors say that sailors came back from a trip sick like hell, and the ones who didn't die on board infested the whole city with their disease. It is time to act before the whole country dies from coughing and cold sweat. I will just play it safe and quarantine the port. I don't mind doing that. I'm at war with Lithuania and Saxony. So Lithuania is probably not going to be a risk to me. They're pretty far away. Oh, wow. Denmark. They actually control a lot of stuff up here. Actually, I can't even get to Saxony. Oh, I can, sorry. I don't really want to siege down a fort. That's just going to take up a lot of resources. Choices we know. There's Dithmarschen. I'm going to help them do some sieging. Esprit de corps. The strain that the military lifestyle puts the men who serve under can, under good circumstances, lead to the development of a spirit of belonging and cooperation that greatly strengthens the armed forces. During the recent conflict with Saxony, we have seen clear signs that our troops are working better together and that they have formed strong bonds of loyalty and duty to the Dutch crown that would have seemed hard to imagine just a few years ago. Again, 3% army professionalism. This is what separates the Dutch troops from all other. Not that I've really done much, have I? I don't know, do I really want to waste resources doing this? I guess I can do some looting at the same time. I don't know. Things to think about. Oh, well, I'm going to help with Saxony. Why not? I can only do what I can do. Let's see what happens with that war. I'm already losing troops. No, I think I'll pause it there and I might call it a day. So I've made more progress. I have 16 loans to go before I can, I guess you could say, resume normal gameplay. That probably sounds fair enough. And I might see if I can't fabricate a bit of a war somewhere just to keep things interesting. So thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate your support. I hope to see you next time.